that that's my great search right now. I read the Bible every day, every morning. I get up in the morning and I say, I'm going to read the Bible first. I really want to grab my phone and see what's going on in the world. I won't tell you what website I want to go to. Hey, political tonight. But I really want to check on the world, or I want to check on, you know, see, but I know I'm going to put God first. I'm going to put God first, I'm going to read the Bible first, I'm going to read the Bible first. And so I do. Now, there are some days I read it after, if I have to rush out, or you know, maybe it's a day or two. But really, the scripture and the word is my absolute, I just can't get enough of it. And I believe that the Lord speaks through me through the word. I believe my life, what I've learned, have you heard of this great devotional by Henry and Richard Blackaby? It's really a great, yes, it's a great devotional. I love this line. Your life is part of God's great design. Every event he allows in your life is designed to make you more like Christ. And I find this really been true in my life. And when I've gone through these big decisions, I realize, am I going to go far away from God, or am I going to go closer to God? Okay, so now, I'm listening for God's higher calling, and then something happened. I go to that next level. Became engaged. See, look familiar? I remember seeing Alf across the room for an audition. I thought, kind of looks like he's under the influence of something. But he was very, I didn't get the role because they said Alf was too intimidated by me and that he wouldn't be able to act if I got the role. I'm like, well, fabulous. But he got the role. But nevertheless, Alec and I fell in love, and it was quite the adventure, shall I say. But it was talk about the Lord guiding me in this process of my life. We became engaged. Remember, I'm a Baptist girl, right? And it was very, very rocky. Alec has been very forthcoming about the devil and demons he was dealing with, but I kind of leave that for him to discuss. But he was dealing with his own demons, and I was drinking. And so, but I knew what this experience was. And this experience kind of, I spiraled into this relationship with him. And it was very turbulent, and we had the dress, we had the invitations. Mom keeps saying, "Don't you remember we went to La Costa in Great?" And I'm like, "No, I don't remember that." But I was almost there. We had the stamps on, we had the dress made. It was a month away. It was very, very close to the wedding, and we called the wedding off. As devastated I was, you know, you go through something like a broken engagement when you're a month away from the wedding, and how devastated and sad I was, and that probably one of the down black holes of my life. But what happened? Alec had started going to some 12-step programs, and so did I. But I went for the friend and the family, right? But when I was 23 years old, I got sober. Thank you. I have 30 years now. I never did drugs. I was too afraid of ever doing anything illegal, but I did drink. And at 23 years of age, I walked into, you know, you're supposed to kind of keep it anonymous. I don't know, 12-step program. And the upper east, west side of New York City, and everyone was smoking. And I was 23 years, walked into this room, and this turned out, what I thought was the worst thing in the world to ever happen to me became the best thing in the world to ever happen to me. And it completely took my spirituality and my reliance upon God to another level. That life for me has been the Lord looking down and shaping my life like a maze, right? And I'm walking through this maze, and I kind of go around the corners, and I see how far I can get until I hit this wall. And the wall turned me this way and that way. And I can always look back and say, I didn't see it then, but I see now.